Hello and welcome to Digital Classes on YouTube channel of Lalbagh Girls Inter College. I'm Mrs. Paul and this lecture of mine is for the students of class 11. Children, we are doing a lesson in prose, The Portrait of a Lady, and today I'll try to complete this lesson with you all. So up till now we have studied that the author has given us a detailed description of how his grandmother looked, how did she behave, what were her daily chores, how did she do her work, day-to-day work, how did she do that, and what was the main essence of the lesson is that here he has described to us readers the three-phase relationship which he was sharing with his grandmother. So in the first phase, you all know, I have already explained that in detail, that he was in the village and he was sharing his entire day with he was all together all day long. He was with his grandmother. And in the second phase, when he came to the city to live in the house and he was sent to a good school, now she was not coming with him to school, or she was not fetching him back from school, but there were little conversations between him and his grandmother. But in the third phase, he says, when he was growing up and he was a young boy, now it was time for him to go to the university. So when he joined the university, he was given a separate room. Let's see. When I went up to the university, I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. Snapped here means broken. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Now her routine changed because she knew that her grandson was a big boy now and there was no need for her to be with him all the time. So how would she spend her time? She used to sit at the spinning wheel and she used to recite her prayers and right from morning till evening. But there was a time in the afternoon while she sat in the veranda breaking the bread into little bits. Now, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirping. Veritable means there were so many birds which came and they sat on her, they were all round her, and this created, and they were all making different kind of noises and sounds. Chirping means the sound or the noise which is made by the birds. So, and this could be heard as though it was a crisscross of confusion, a lot of some kind of confusion that was created, and there was a lot of noise and there was a hush, but this was the time which she enjoyed most. Some came and perched on her legs. Perch means came and sat down on her legs, others on her shoulders, and some even sat on her head. She smiled but never shooed them away. She never tried to shoo them away. It used to be the happiest hour of the day for her. Now, what is he saying? That he's saying that she used to sit at the spinning wheel. Spinning wheel means a household machine which is attached to a wheel to spin yarn. And because they have used this word with some specific notification, so you can just note down, a veritable bedlam of chirping means here it refers to the noise and confusion caused by the chirping of the sparrows. And veritable, children, you can describe it to yourself as something which is very interesting or unusual. Bedlam means confusion, and chirping, as I said, the sound made by the birds. But she never shooed them away. Shooing away means making a person or animal go away by shouting. So here the author is saying that now when he was given a different room, that common relationship between him and his grandmother was broken. It was snapped. Now she used to sit at her spinning wheel and she used to recite her prayer for the whole day. When I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years, he say. And at her age, no one could never tell. No one could say anything about it because he is saying she was very old. So initially he is saying that he did not expect to see her back when he returned from abroad. But my grandmother could. She was not very sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but she did not show any emotion. She was sad, she was nostalgic, but she did not show her emotions. She kept on reciting her prayers on the beads of her rosary, and she silently kissed the forehead of the author and he left. But he's saying, after 5 years, I came back home and I was met by her at the station. She did not look a day older. There was no change in her and she looked the same as she was when the author was leaving. And she still had no time for words, only she while she clasped me in her arms. Now clasp me here means when she took the author into her embrace, she took him into her embrace and she hugged him. I could hear her reciting her prayers, and even on the first day of my arrival, that is when he came on the very first day, even that time her happiest moments were when she was spending her time in the afternoon with the sparrows and she was talking to them, and he's saying whom she fed longer that day and with frivolous rebukes. Frivolous rebukes means not having any serious purpose. Lightheartedly, she was rebuking means scolding also. She was talking to the birds. When the author decided to go abroad for further studies, he believed that it would be the last time that he would see her. But when he came back, he was very happy to see her back. When he came back after 5 years, she came to meet him at the station. She looked as if she did 5 years ago, not a day older. All right. Now, in the next paragraph, the author is saying, in the evening, a change came over her. For some reason, there was a change that came over her. She did not pray. This was her daily routine. She had done it for years, but that very day, she did not pray. She collected all the women of the neighborhood, got an old drum, and started to sing. Now, this was very strange because most of the time, she was spending in prayers and reciting her prayers or being quiet and being secluded. But this day she collected all the women of the neighborhood and she started to sing. For several hours she thumped the sagging skin of the dilapidated drum and sang of the homecoming of warriors. The song which are sung when the warriors come back home, she sang those songs in excitement and in joy. Thumped means by hitting, beating a drum by hitting. And then it has been mentioned sagging skin. Sagging means skin that is sinking down because it was very old. So the sagging skin of the dilapidated drum, the loose surface of the worn out drum, because it was very old and it was not a new drum. So but then she, just for the sake of entertaining others and because she was trying to express her happiness, her joy, so she sang for a very long time, and definitely she was exhausted. An evening she did not follow her routine of praying. She collected women from neighborhood and she sang songs for a long hour, and the whole family persuaded her to stop as she might get ill due to exhaustion, because she was so overexcited that people in the family and the house members were very, they were kind of worried that she was so old, so she would get exhausted and she could have taken ill. So they were asking her to stop singing. The next morning she fell ill. It was a mild fever. The doctors told them that it would go away, but she took it differently. According to her, now she knew, it is said the person, that a person who is departing comes to know by his insight that it is time for him or her to leave. So when the doctor came, he just saw her and he said that she would be fine. But she took it differently. According to her, she would die soon as her end was near. She started chanting prayers and she did not want to waste her last hours in talking to anybody. She did not talk to anybody. We protested, but she ignored our protests. She lay peacefully in her bed praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. A peaceful pallor spread on her face and we knew that she was dead. There was silence and there was a kind of smile, and a pallor means here an unhealthy pale appearance that could make the people of the house understand that she was no more and that she had died. So though the family had tried to stop her because they were afraid that she would be too exhausted and she would be taken sick, but she did not listen to anybody. And the next day when she was literally sick, she said that her end was near. So she did not listen to the heedings and the requests of the family members. She just kept on chanting her prayers, and silently she was quiet and the rosary fell down from her hands, and people in the house could know that she was no more. So in the end, the author says, we lifted her from the bed and as the custom, we covered her with a red shroud, put her on the ground, and after hours of mourning, we went for making the arrangements of the funeral. Now, this was a very strange sight, that when the sun was about to set, he's saying, the veranda and the room were filled with a blaze of golden light. We stopped halfway in the courtyard, all over the veranda, in her room, right up to where she lay dead, stiff and wrapped in the red shroud. Thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. There was no chirping, because earlier in the previous paragraph he's saying there was a crisscross and of chirping, and there was so much of confusion and noise and hush. And now when the birds were sitting, there was absolutely pin drop silence. The birds were sitting quietly. We felt sorry for the birds, and my mother fed some bread for them. The mother thought that because they were habituated of getting food from the grandmother, so she just went up to the kitchen and she brought some pieces of bread and broke them and tried to feed the birds. But the when we carried, what I was saying, the sparrows took no notice of the bread. That is, when they were fed, they did not eat, because they came to know that she was no more, and they were silently, quietly giving respect to her, and they were mourning for the loss of the old grandmother. When we carried my grandmother's corpse means the dead body, off, they flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs into the dustbin. What he's saying, when she was taken away for the last rites, then those bread pieces which were not eaten by the birds, they were thrown into the dustbin. That is, even the birds knew that she was no longer there. So with this, children, we come to the end of the